John Wick, Section 4 gets right from where Part 3 finished, with John Wick in a good place again and mended, all set after the high table. Most of the fourth film sees John taking on that difficult conflict, beginning with getting back to confront the senior. The senior that took John's finger and wedding band in Part 3 is gone, yet John executes the one supplanting him, beginning a full-scale battle with the high table. Wick goes on the run, however the blowback from his demonstrations washes over those leftover companions he has. The high table releases the distinguished and twisted Marquis Vincent de Greymont, Bill Skarsgård, to deal with the John Wick circumstance. Yet the Marquis' strategies end up being incredibly severe. The Marquis makes his presentation by getting Winston and Sharon and making them witness the destruction of the New York City mainland before he executes Sharon to show Winston a thing or two. To find John, the Marquis employs as well as forces a few profoundly gifted professional killers, including John's old, blind, companion Kane, Donnie Yen, and the tracker, Shamir Anderson. The Marquis likewise sends his own group of tip-top high table masters out on the kill, and it turns into a competition to see who gets to John Wick first. That pursuit goes through Japan's Osaka mainland, the Ruska Roma HQ in Berlin, and afterward to Paris, where John should fight his approach to defying the Marquis and Kane in a gun duel. The provisions of the duel are straightforward. If John and his support Winston wins, his excommunicado is lifted, while Wilson haggles to get the mainland and his status as supervisor back. On the off chance that Kane wins, he is liberated from all commitments to the high table and his little girl stays safe. For John Wick, the stakes are critical regardless of the result. The duel requires John and Kane to shoot single projectiles at each other at 30 speeds, then 20, and afterward 10, where missing isn't a choice. Both John and Kane experience serious wounds in the initial two rounds. However, in the third round, John keeps his slug down, tricking the Marquis into thinking the duel is finished. The Marquis haughtily steps in to polish John off and on second thought gets the last slug John saved, directly in the brow. John Wick, Part 4 closures with John Wick passing on from his wounds on the means of the sanctuary where the duel is held. John is covered close to his significant other Helen, Bridget Moynihan, by Winston and the Bowery ruler, with his gravestone bearing the engraving John needed, cherishing spouse. John's demise serves a round-trip turn for the series. He was liberated from administration as a professional killer in the wake of winning the duel. However, the Marquis accurately got down on that, assuming he continued to live, he would keep on accepting life as an executioner. John's passing is his definitive delivery, as he will kick the bucket a fairly honorable man, fit to be brought together with his significant other. Nonetheless, despite the fact that John Wick bites the dust toward the end, John Wick, Part 4 makes a point to tell fans the establishment isn't finished at this point.